Hey everyone, I think we're live. It always spins for a while, and I don't know if we're officially live. Now it says we're live. So I just talk for a couple minutes before it actually goes live every single time. But oh my gosh, Facebook Live is working, which is fantastic. I'm live from my computer on my business page, and I think we're sharing to my group. So I feel like for the first time in months, we like everything is working according to plans. This is good news. So good. Well, I am excited to be here with you guys tonight. Happy Monday. For those of you that don't know me, I am Becky Launder and I run the show over at myconsultanttraining.com and also I'm the founder of the Modern Direct Seller Academy. And I'm excited to be here with you guys tonight. I usually like jot down some notes before I go, but I don't know. I don't write down like a whole lot. I usually can kind of just talk. I guess it's my gift. I can just blab and talk. Hey, Shelly, good to see you. As you guys are joining, say hello. But tonight I looked at what was on my schedule because I have a content calendar where I try to kind of keep an eye on, different things I'm talking about at different points during the month. And I looked at my notes for tonight and it like kind of gave me a heart attack. Like I felt like I wasn't really prepared. Because I'm talking about myself. Does anyone else feel that way? Like it's so much easier to talk about other things and talk about other people. And when you have to talk about yourself, it's like writing your own resume or writing your own bio. You're like, oh, like what do I say? So this is what I have on my calendar, and this is what I'm going to talk about tonight. A little about my story on how I got into direct sales and this is what it says, giving hope to those that are new to direct sales. I'm not sure we'll do that, but I am going to share my story because I think that, I want you guys to know who you're listening to here. I throw content at you in your inbox and on social media all the time. And, it might be good to know like a little bit about my background and a little bit about my story. So that's what we're going to do. And I am live every Monday night at 7 o'clock Pacific, 10 o'clock Eastern, which I know is super late for my East Coasters. Eventually, I'm going to do these during regular office hours, normal hours, but life is still pretty crazy over here at our house. I don't know about you guys, but here at our house, I mean, it's summer now, so the kids are home and my husband's working from home and things are just a little bit crazy. So these late night Mondays kind of work for me. Hey, Ashton. Yeah, they kind of work. So we're gonna stick to it for just a little while longer, and then maybe here in a couple months we'll get back to like daytime lives. But there's always a replay, so if you're laying in bed falling asleep right now, you don't have to stay up and listen. You can catch the replay tomorrow. But if you are on live, say hello. Yeah, and I'll just share a little bit of, my story and my background and how I got started in direct sales and how that path has kind of taken me to where I am now. I don't know why. This is like, I'm not nervous, but like, it is a little bit weird when you're talking about yourself, right? So let me back up. Let's start at the beginning. So my background is in marketing strategy and operations and analytics. And for a really long time, over 10 years, I worked for a nonprofit organization called the Center for Creative Leadership, which is a huge global training company. They're amazing. Look them up. And I spent 10 years there. So right out of college, I started working there. And I was given so much opportunity. I moved into so many different roles during my time there. I did my master's degree while I was there in leadership and management. So I had the opportunity, like I always laugh that I got married while I was there in my corporate job. I had my first baby. Like I went through all the things. I got my graduate degree, all of that in my 10 years working at the Center for Creative Leadership. So during that time, hey Lisa, glad you're on. I pretty much grew up in a training company. Like whether I realized that in the moment or not, like I knew all about personality types and I was running a young women's leadership program and I was surrounded by PhDs in organizational psychology and like I was learning about leadership day in and day out. And on the marketing strategy side, I was never doing copywriting or graphics or like when we think about marketing, we think about branding. I never did any of that. I was always on the back end. So I was looking at industry trends, I was looking at competitive analysis, I did pricing strategy, naming. I got to name products, which sounds really fun in theory until you're naming leadership programs. Right? I always said, I wish that I got to name nail polish. Because that would be so much more fun. But I did all of that. I was a product manager and it was a ton of fun. Like I learned so much. And like I said, I really truly grew up in my job there. And so much so that I had my first baby, Mackenzie, and went back to work full time after I had her. It was kind of hard, but I also realized like I'm probably not cut out to be a stay-at-home mom. You could probably ask my kids what the last couple months have been. They're like, nope. She's not a teacher. She's not a stay-at-home mom. Mommy likes to work. So I went back to work full time after I had Mackenzie. And then when I had Cody, I was like, things are getting a little bit more challenging. I have two kids. One's in preschool, one's at home with a nanny. Working. This is a little bit crazy. So I drew out my maternity leave as long as I could. Anyone else do that? Where I'm like, I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna go back, but I'm gonna go back like, 15 hours a week, 17 hours a week, 20 hours a week. So I gradually got back into it until I realized that, I was looking for a little bit more flexibility. So I, around the same time, started my book business with Usborne Books and More. Many of you guys know that. Those are my roots. And shout out to all my book ladies on. And with my consultant training, with my book business, it had grown pretty big. I had a really big team and I was making a good amount of income. And I found myself at my corporate job, my day job, kind of daydreaming about different marketing strategies I was going to put in place in my direct sales business and different ways I was going to run recruiting events. And my mind just kind of kept spinning and spinning until finally, I had the conversation with Jeremy, my husband. And was like, I just want to go back. I think I just want to go back part time. Like, I think that that's going to be a better fit for me, right? So I did. I went back part time and continued to grow my direct sales business. And for anyone that's been around for a little while, shout out if you've been around for a little while, you know that myconsultanttraining.com originally started as a training hub for direct sellers with Usborne Books and More. Like that's just kind of how it started, is I was looking for a way to streamline my training that I was creating for my team to make it easier for them. And as a leader, I was getting tired of telling the same thing over and over and over again. So I just started recording videos, throwing them up on this website, not really thinking a whole lot of it. And if you go back and watch some of those original videos, oh man, I ran across one the other day and I was like, should I delete this off of YouTube? Like the whole video, I'm like staring over here talking. Just goes to show the videos take practice because the whole time I'm just staring over here because I'm watching myself on the camera instead of looking at the hole. Does anyone know what I'm talking about? Nikki, you hear me? Oh my gosh. But those videos, they were like, they were great because it was basically just me talking to somebody and explaining like this is what you should do in the beginning of your business. Now that you've done that, do this, right? So any questions I got more than like two or three times, I just recorded a video about and I started, blogging and throwing it all up there on the website. So fast forward a few years later, I was training my team, but then I was also training others within our company. And then I started noticing others outside of the direct sales company I was with were starting to visit the site for various things. So I ended up making a little bit of a switch and, well, a big switch, really. I went from books to fashion and had a really great opportunity to lead a direct sales team here on the West Coast. So I ended up finally stepping away from my book business, launching my fashion business, and that continued to grow as well until I finally, hey Jessica, we're just talking about you. Oh my gosh. And then I was like, okay, myconsultanttraining.com started blowing up. Like people, I don't even know where people were coming from, but they were finding the videos, they were finding the training. And at that point, I had made the decision that anything that I was creating should really work across the industry. Like, it didn't make sense just to make training for one company because there were so many similarities no matter what company you're with. It's kind of the same format. Yeah, maybe a different comp plan. Some things kind of change here and there, but really, like, it's the same story, different day. It's the same process you're taking to launch and grow your business. So I started really generalizing the content. Our first course that we offered was launch your website in a weekend. This is really Jeremy's baby. And launch your website in a weekend was a course to show people how to create their own website. So everyone loved my BeckysBookCorner.com website. So we created this course to show people how to exactly do that. And we gave them a template, we gave them training, we walked them through step by step how to do that. And then I kind of took it to the next level and thought, well, maybe I'll create a training, a course that walks people through launching their business to scaling their business. So that's where the Grow Your Direct Sales Biz Bundle courses came from. And they line up directly with my book, 52 Tips to Build a Thriving Direct Sales Business. They kind of go hand in hand. And those courses did pretty well. Like, people bought them, but I knew that there was something missing. I knew that there was a price. The price point was a little bit high, especially if you were starting out. I felt like it was really important to make this training accessible for people. And I also realized that I knew people needed the training. And if any other leaders out there, let me know if you resonate with this. I knew that they needed the training, but they didn't know that they needed the training, right? So I knew how valuable it was, but when you're at the beginning stages of your business, making an investment in a big old training course series just didn't quite make sense. So I think in business, whether it's direct sales or any other business, a lot of it is like throwing things at the wall and seeing what sticks, right? So I had my book, I had my courses, we had our website course, we had a whole lot of different things going on. And then we kind of figured things out, right? So we launched the Modern Direct Seller Academy back in October. So it really hasn't even been open for a year. How crazy is that? Like, I feel like all of this, like, time flies by so quickly. And now we are almost 500 members strong, and it's less than a year old. So it's grown tremendously, and now we've bundled all of that into the academy. So you have access to the courses, you have access to some of the other downloads that we've created, plus the community, which is really exciting as well. So beyond that, it's also been a really fun process because I've had the opportunity to work with new direct sales companies and companies that are just getting started and helping them really think through their direct sales strategy and the training that they're offering their consultants. So it's definitely been a journey. It's been almost exactly a year since I've actually been out in the field selling for a direct sales company. Now everything that I'm offering is my own, which is fun and exciting. Hey, Lindsay. It still feels different from time to time. I'm like, oh man, wish I could go do a vendor event. I see like cute pictures of everyone's vendor event set up, and I'm like, I miss doing those. I loved doing vendor events or hearing about how everyone has really, changed the way that they're partying online, whether that's Facebook or if they're using Squee or if they're using Zoom. It looks, even in a year, there's so much that has changed in a year. So I do miss that to some extent, but I've really kind of honed in on my passion over the last couple of years that my passion is really around strategy and training. Like, that's my sweet spot. That's what I'm good at. That's what I love doing. I love working with other direct sellers and helping them figure out their strategy, helping them really take their business to the next level and build their confidence. And it's so funny how things come full circle. So back when I worked in my corporate job, I wasn't training people. I wasn't in the classroom. Like, those were the PhD those were the people that were out there training corporate leaders, and I was always behind the scenes. But I do think that it was a little bit in my blood. Like, I could never get away from training, and now here I am actually doing my own training. Fast forward, a couple years later. So I don't know. No matter where you're at in your business, just know that it is part of a journey. It is part of getting to that next thing or that next level, and everything's going to look different. a year from now, and it's going to look dramatically different 2 years from now. So it's just been an exciting journey. And one exciting thing, if you are sticking with me here live, I'll share with you. We've just hit a pretty big milestone in our business and in our family too. That, you guys know Jeremy, my husband's been working kind of behind the scenes for years. Like, we don't watch Netflix at night. We like sit down at our computers and we work together at night. So he's been working behind the scenes in the business for a long time, doing all the website work. He does all the finances, all of our affiliate programs, and a whole lot more. He does a lot behind the scenes. And we balance each other out really well because there's stuff that I would never want to do that he loves to do, and vice versa. It would take a lot to get him like on live videos, chatting with everyone on a regular basis. That would like drain all of his energy, right? So the exciting news in our family is, no, I'm not pregnant, but Jeremy is actually coming to work full time with myconsultanttraining.com and the Modern Direct Seller Academy, and we couldn't be more excited about that. So here in about a month, a little bit over, I think it might even be a little bit less than a month, he will officially be leaving his electrical engineering job to come work on the team. And so it's exciting because we've been doing this together for years, but it will officially be maybe during daytime hours, depending upon if our kids go back to school. And we're just going to be able to do more and do it faster and bigger. And I don't know. I'm really excited about it. So that's our exciting news in our world. And how crazy that here it was not that long ago that I was having a conversation with him about leaving my corporate job and how we were like so nervous about it. We weren't quite sure what that was going to look like. And it's been on my, yes, me, Jessica, I haven't even talked to you. It is exciting. It's been on my vision board or my goals list that I write in every day for years now that we've, would actually be able to work together. So, it is exciting, and I can't wait to see what's next for us and, just continue to watch the business grow as we're able to support all of you. So that's a little bit of my story and also what's to come, which is exciting. I did want to mention, because, I gotta mention it, we do have the Academy opening on Wednesday. So if you are not yet in the Modern Direct Seller Academy, you may want to think about it because we are going to open the doors on Wednesday. It'll be open until the 30th, so the end of the month. But then after that, we are actually going to close the doors for a little while. And it'll probably be at least 3 months, if not longer, before we reopen. So if you're interested in kind of getting in and finishing up the summer strong and setting yourself up for the fall, this would be the time to do it. And while we do that, when we reopen the doors in the fall, there definitely will be a bit of a price increase. So if you want to get in at the lowest price and get in time for the fall season, definitely check your inbox on Wednesday when we reopen the Academy. So that's a little bit about what I have going on, a little bit of my story. I don't know why I was like kind of nervous telling you guys all of that, but it's an exciting place to be, lots of good stuff happening, and I love that I get to work with all of you and support you and see all of your successes in your direct sales businesses. That totally fills me up, and it's just my favorite. So I hope you guys have a good Monday. I will be back with you next Monday at 7 o'clock Pacific, 10 o'clock Eastern. And next Monday, we'll be talking about goal setting and finishing up the month strong. So make sure you mark your calendar for next Monday. Check your inbox on Wednesday when the Academy opens. And if you're not in our free group, I will post the link over to our free group too. Okay, you guys, I hope you have a wonderful week, and I look forward to talking to you soon. Thanks for letting me share a little bit of my story with you. All right, take care.